and saw two ships standing by the lake. But it was actually standing by the guard of Richard. Now, in other, y'all might not get this thing. The ships are standing by guard of Richard. So the ships of both Paul and Eph are sitting in the garden. They're sitting in the garden, and there's two ships. There's a ship to hear, there's a ship to listen. See, if you'd have heard God, you would have listened to the devil. Okay. Come on. See, if you'd have heard God, you would have more than enough to listen to the devil. You've been thinking what's going on there. Now, I just throw it out there because it's a parable, and if you got to hear it here, you can hear and you get your revelation. But if you tell somebody, amen. See, number one, he said, and two ships standing by the lake. But the fishermen, oh, y'all don't want to talk to me, were going out of them. Now, I want you to know there were fishermen in both ships. It's like this here. There were fishermen. Now, when you said fisherman, a fisherman is somebody that has the power to fish or to bring in the fish. You can bring in a fish, whether you go down to the lake and get a fish out, and the first fish you get out, or the first fish you catch, reach in his mouth and take some money out and pay for us because he's at the guard of riches. I don't want to talk to me. But if you get a net full, so you might be fishing, but you might be fishing with a rod or a pole. But these are fishermen. So they fishing with a net. So when you got people in church, you love people, you got to move people around. Because you ever notice some people, you can tell when people's in trouble, when their lives ain't right, or what's going on, or they just barely exist, and things in their life ain't right, because they'll be like this here. Side for a minute, and there's a lot of disorder in your life, and you need to get your life right because you like to lose it. You like to do that thing because you. I just don't feel that way. But I ain't got no problem with you. You can do it. On the children. But my only thing is, I ain't trying to be funny, I just listen to God. I don't know your business. I'm just a receiver. I'm just putting it, don't care about it, man. I can't change your check. I can't go to Washington get your check. I can't go to your bar. All I'm doing is delivering what they done already cleared through customs and branch. Hello, somebody. See, people that are on those games and stuff like that, on that thing constantly like that, you have to understand what God is telling you about riches and why he's telling you about the garden of riches and because of the destruction of the poor or their poverty. But the word, Lazarus means God will help. And the word Lazarus of Bethan means, the word Bethan actually means, oh, y'all don't want to talk to me. The word Bethan means poor/poverty. So he's Lazarus of Bethan because he's Lazarus of a poor spirit and he dwells in poverty and he's not deep enough. You understand what I'm saying? So, but he's the same Lazarus that's kin to Mary that washed Jesus' feet. That was the deepest thing in Simon's house. That was the deepest thing in the church. They got her brother Lazarus raised from the dead. She is the Rahab of the New Testament. They had a whole family saved. What y'all don't want to talk about? I'm just saying, if you go, but you got to come off the shore. You got to cast out. The ship is cast out. You understand what I'm saying? And what you got to understand, how I want to tell you about this ship and about the Alpha and Omega. And by the Alpha is the Word. It's in the beginning was Word. So when you hear the Word, if you hear the Word, when you go through and you know that the Word of God speaks unto you, Jesus speaks unto you in spirit, and they're alive. Hello, somebody. Amen. Then you begin to realize that Jesus is saying something a lot deeper than what you have been. Huh? See, number one, these are fishermen. And the reason I carry the young children over to the young, not children, young men, young, sit in the church, don't want to do right. Instead of being leaders, they want to play a game. Because the word computer on a numerology chart equals 666. That's what the word, that's what C-O-M-P-U-T, computer, E-R. On the numerology chart, when you set it up with the numerology, it equals 666. So you was playing that playing with a game on 666, and they call it the internet, so they have not only got you in a net, but they got you in the internet, and you follow behind that internet, so you losing it on the outer net. Y'all don't want to talk to me. And you're always angry and upset, and you always got less than enough, and you barely existed, and you listen to God, but you can't hear God. God speaks up to you himself. But you will hear God, you listen to God, because in order for a snake to bite you, a snake charms you. See, if a snake charms you for a person, if he gets you to doing this here and doing this here and doing that there, and get all the information from you, pretty soon he'll get you to come on your locator, and he'll know where you at, and pretty soon he'll put a chip in your right hand or in your forehead, because you're already fed into the concept, you're already following behind the kids are under the... But I'm just saying that there are two ships there, and there are more than one net. And he was touring all night, but it wasn't touring with God's word. And he said, nevertheless, at thy word, so let me show you something. Just take a fish, but somebody that fishes on down at the bridge, and he catch fish with a rod. And people say, oh, he's a fisherman. Listen, no, he's just fishing. He's not a fisherman. Amen. So if you see somebody, even if they throw that out there and snatch with no bait, you say, oh, well, he's a fisherman. No, he's not a fisherman. He just said, see, let me show you something. Brother Darrell was telling me about something about his business. And he was telling me about how a roofer they were doing. But you got really a roofer, you just roofing. You understand what I'm saying? The concept was because if you're a roofer, that means that I can talk to you anything about any type of roofing, and you already have the knowledge, you already have the experience, you have everything, because you are not a roofer. These were fishermen. And in other words, the fishermen in the first ship of listening were very experienced men. See, Satan has a very experienced crew with it. They were angels that fell from heaven. They been up above looking down low. They hooked into their GPS, and this ship over here refused to hook into their God PS. See, if you're born again, you see the things above, and if you hook up from there, you can look down there, and you can look past the face. If you have the ability to hook up there, see, when you hook up there, when you hook up into your internet system, it has the ability to carry you deeper into studies than you've been able to get all the books. But if you hook up into that, God fears it has the ability to get you deeper to look past the face. The word face actually means surface. So you look past the surface and you see the need. You look past the sin and you'll see the need. See, God looked past man's side and saw the need. See, that's what perfect love does, though. Agape love is love where they associate it. It becomes a special love card of it. So they gave it the concept of godly love. It did not necessarily mean godly love, but that's what the ascribers through time with the definition of the word ascribe to godly love as unconditional love, and they start calling it agape love. But it's actually perfect love. Hello, somebody. Amen. So when you began to fish and you began to be a fisherman, you got to understand that the devil is very good at what he does. He's wiser than any beast. So I don't see how you think you can listen to God and ride in the ship with God and be resistant to God and listen to rumors from the other ship. See, because if you listen to rumors from the other ship, God will tell you to cast out into the deep and cast your net. And the ship over here will tell you, man, we done already been out there. So you got to get off the party line so you have an ear to hear. See, somebody has problems with their bills, and they have to pray all the time about their bills and God meet their needs. But the reason you have to pray all the time about your bills and God instead of meeting your needs is because he's not answering you before you call, because you are not in the flow, and you're not in the flow because you're still on the surface of things, and you need to go deeper if y'all don't want to talk to me, because God's thoughts are deep, are very deep, not just deep, but very deep. See, you don't think like God, you don't have a mind like God. He said, let this mind be in you. Hello, somebody. He said, my thoughts are not your thoughts. But as the heaven is above, high above the earth, so is my thoughts above yours. He said, mine is deep and very deep. Hello, somebody. He said, the deeper place you got at that seat, but the heaven. Hello, somebody. Amen. So you got to go deep because you're in a garden of riches, but you're in a garden of riches, and you're listening to everybody and everything trying to find out what you're supposed to be doing to get yourself on board or to get your bills paid or your thing met instead of hearing God. Amen. In the garden, because there are two ships. In other words, there are two trees in the garden. There's a tree that will tell you you can be a God and you can do, but there's another one over here that's a tree of life that say even if you be a God, if you die, it ain't going to do nothing to you. Hello, somebody. Amen. And see, you can eat the fruit of this tree, but you can eat the fruit of this tree, but you ain't even have to get an orange, a lemon, a fruit of this tree over here. All you gotta do is get one of the leaves, because the leaves of the tree. Hello, somebody, amen. Had a cow, amen. So you need to tap into that particular power. God wants you to tap. See, if you a roofer, you know how to roof. Amen. And let me show you something. I'm sure with God. I'm riding. You're a fisherman. Yeah, we're a fisherman. If you're a fisherman, you know how to fish, amen. Now you think about it. You didn't think about it. Now, I didn't come and say, I want to be a fisherman. And you done trained me to be a fisherman. And you done trained me to be a fisherman for a year. Well, roofing, we got roofing in. But yeah, you done trained me to be a roofer for a year. And I'm still a roofer, so. And you done trained me for 2 years. And I still, you done trained me for 5 years. And because Derek, he talking to me, he said, Wayne know how to do this. Yeah, I said, no, I do. I got this and that and don't know how to do, you know what I mean? That, but you've been here all the time, but you don't know how to. So I really don't have that much confidence. I really don't have, you know, if you've been in church long enough, nobody should have to tell you what you're supposed to be doing or whatever, because it's no different than being a fisherman or a roofer or whatever. You wouldn't put this store much trust on somebody that you know that you got to pump up and tell them to do this and tell them to do that, because they're not really a fisherman or really a roofer. They're out there to get a paycheck, but they ain't written the hell on somebody. Amen. They married to a rich man and get what they can get instead of loving a rich man so they can spoil it. I don't want to talk to them. See, See, so I'm just saying that, amen. See, when you love the Lord, you can't, you ever love somebody and you're too tired to go see them? Mm-mm. I can't wait to see them again. I've been thinking about them all day long. I've been patting my feet, winking my eyes, huh? I had a daydream and I came asleep. So it gets to the point whether you love or you seek it what you can get. You understand what I'm saying? Now if you just in it, see the Bible says seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things will be added to you. In other words, if you seek the word and believe the word, if you hear the word and act on the word from your faith of the word, then in the garden of riches, you'll have more than enough. See, when your Simon is on the right side and not on the left side. See, because we were raised up as children, we said the left side be riches and the right side be life. So now I'm more concerned with my life than I am about riches, because if I'm rich and don't live long, if I live long enough, I will be rich. If I don't be rich enough in knowledge, I'll be rich. See what I'm saying? I'd be rich enough to know I didn't even want that mess, but I didn't want to be ducking all them people to be hell somebody. And I just lived and I'm glad I hell somebody. Amen. So Solomon said, feed me with food that's convenient for me. Amen. But there's an Alpha and Omega. And he said, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word in the beginning spells Alpha, because he is the beginning. Amen. He's the first and he's the last. Amen. He'll have the first word and he'll have the last word. It's for God to get it increased. It's for God to plant it. It's for the man of God to water it. And it's for God to give it the increase. Hello, somebody. So if you hear the Alpha, you'll receive the Omega. You understand what I'm saying? But if you just listen to the Alpha, I mean, if you just listen to the Alpha, that means that you have a part of life and you listen to the Alpha, but you skeptically listen to the Alpha. So when you get to the man of God, you're going to hear, you're going to listen, but you skeptically listen because you hear everybody else. And when he get to you, he's going to be able to perform a few miracles. He's going to be performing a lot because you know so much about him instead of studying to know the God that's in him. God told me like this the other day. He said, you can have people around you that has an investigative spirit, an FBI spirit. They want to know everything you about. They want to watch a sermon than to hear a sermon. So they're investigating you. And if they investigate you, they're going to miss God. You understand what I'm saying? See, because the devil will throw a stone and hide his hand. See what I'm saying? So you can't even keep up with him with that concept. If you sitting there trying to catch three card Molly, you're gonna be messed up and messed, broke and disgusted. Hello, somebody. I'm just saying, amen. It takes an outside man to catch that. Hello, somebody. I'm just saying, amen. So you got the Alpha and you got the Omega. You got in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. Because when Jesus came, he was Son of Man, Son of God. Amen. So the Word was with the man. Amen. But the Word was God. Amen. Hello, somebody. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God and the Word was God. You got the Alpha and you got the Omega. And the Alpha caused the man to be hooked up with the Omega. In other words, Jesus said, if you love me, in the book of John, he said, if you love me, that myself and my Father will come to you and make our abide, amen? And when we make our abide with you, we'll be God in you, so it'll be the Alpha in you, so it'll be the Alpha and Omega. It'll be the is, was, and always shall be the Almighty. Hello, somebody. So, and if you get to hear that, if you begin to hear God, You won't just be tussling and rustling and toying all night long, because he didn't say we were toying all day long. He said we've been in a dark place. We've been in the night and we've been scuffling in the night, but not any kind of light. because we were listening for how we, you know, some people walk through and you talk, just follow my voice now. Just follow me. Just listen to me now. Listen to the sound of that and you can hear. Just listen and you can walk. Amen. But if I hear you and get light in myself, if you just tell me where I'm supposed to go, a lot of times I'll ask somebody, I say, just tell me this, that, and that. They think I'm a listener. And they'll say, well, you go here. I said, well, what you do not? And they'll say, well, you go here. They won't be, see, it's the devil playing tricks because he's trying to implant in you listening instead of hearing. If you just told me where I need to go, I know how to get there. I'm not going to turn to the right hand or to the left hand. I might tell you to go wait somewhere. You understand what I'm saying? But you ain't going to wait because you listen. And if you don't watch out, that'll cross-pollinate in everything you do. And then you'll come, you'll have that concept. And until you see what I'm saying, now the thing about love is perfect love casts out all fear. See, when somebody tell you to go somewhere and wait, and all you do is well. But see, Elijah told Naaman to go bathe in the River Jordan. It wasn't the River Jordan. It was the word that God spoke through the prophet that was going to clean the prophet. And the prophet was, and Naaman was dirty because he was listening to the king but not obeying God. And I can prove it because Naaman told him, said, when I get back to Syria, my king is going to want me to praise that false god. He said, I'm going to be doing it this time, but I've already heard God. Hello, somebody. Amen.